Hi friends, this is Sandeep Reddy Kankanala, Verified Educator at an Academy. Friends, those who are feeling difficult to memorize GK and those who are not able to score good marks in GK, you can follow my tricks. My tricks are very helpful in all competitive exams. Still now, those who are feeling difficult to memorize and those who are not able to score good marks, my tricks will be definitely helpful to you. Till now, I uploaded 300 videos covering Indian geography, history, economy, polity, and general science. If you watch these 300 videos, 50% to 80% of your syllabus will be covered. So friends, these are the very unique tricks. If you want to see these 300 videos, you can see the links below in the description, or else download an Academy app from the Play Store and search Sandeep Kankanala so that you can see all my videos. So friends, today we are going to see very important topic, very important. Whatever the competitive exam you write, 100% sure we can expect one question. So if you watch this 1 minute video, definitely one mark will be in your pocket. So now we are going to see very important definitions. See, I think you are very familiar with this, right? So most of the people get confused. See, the conversion of matter from solid to liquid is called melting. The conversion of solid to liquid is called melting. You have to remember, the conversion of solid to liquid is called melting. Conversion of matter from liquid to gas is called vaporization. Conversion from liquid to gas is called vaporization. The same way, conversion of gas to liquid is called condensation. Conversion of gas to liquid is called condensation. Conversion of liquid to solid is called freezing. Conversion of liquid to solid is called freezing. Conversion of solid to directly to gas is called sublimation. Conversion of solid to gas directly is called sublimation. Conversion of gas to solid is called reverse sublimation. These are the very important definitions. This may look simple, but you will get confused. You have to remember, the conversion of solid to liquid is called melting, liquid to gas is called vaporization, gas to liquid is called condensation, liquid to solid is called freezing, solid to gas is called sublimation, gas to solid is called reverse sublimation. Definitely friends, I can say 100% sure, definitely we can expect one question in every competitive exam. So please by heart this table, it is very important. So friends, if you want to see my previous videos, download an Academy app from the Play Store, or else you can see all the topics exactly down the video in the description. Thank you. Share this video to your friends. Thank you friends. Hi friends, this is Sandeep Reddy Kankanala, Verified Educator at an Academy. Friends, till now I uploaded 300 videos. All these are tricks related to Indian geography, history, economy, polity, and general science. If you watch all these 300 videos, definitely 40 to 50 marks will be in your pocket. So friends, these are the very unique tricks. I think you never find these kind of tricks. If you want to see these 300 videos, you can see the links below in the description, exactly down the video, or else download an Academy app from the Play Store and search Sandeep Kankanala so that you can see all my videos. So friends, today we are going to see very important topic, tricks to remember mountain passes. Tricks to remember mountain passes. Do you know what is the meaning of mountain passes? Do you know what it is? See, let's see the definition. A mountain pass is a navigable route through a mountain range. A mountain pass is a navigable road through a mountain range, right? Do you understand the meaning? So there are different types of mountain passes in the different states. So this is a very important question in the exam point of view. We can expect one question. So let's see this. See, first we are going to see passes in Jammu Kashmir. Tricks to remember passes in Jammu Kashmir. There are two important passes in Jammu Kashmir. They are Kardungla Pass and Banihal Pass. Once again, Kardungla Pass and Banihal Pass. So our target is to remember these two passes and names. Let's see here. In Jammu Kashmir, the first three letters is JAM, JAM, right? JAM, JAM. So just remember it as traffic jam. Just remember it as traffic jam, right? Coming to Kardungla Pass, here you can see KHAR. Its pronunciation is car. So just remember Kardungla Pass as car. Kardungla Pass as car. Coming to Banihal Pass, here you can see BAN, BAN. So just remember it as BAN, right? It has BAN. BAN is nothing but stopped, right? It is stopped, right? So let us assume BAN means stopped. So we got total three words, JAM, CAR, BAN. Now I am going to make a trick using these three words. I am going to frame them. See, there is a traffic jam in the city, so all cars are banned. There is a traffic jam in the city, so all cars are banned. Okay friends, if you by heart this sentence, it is easy to remember. All the passes in Jammu Kashmir, there is a traffic jam in the city, so all cars are banned. Let's see next one. Passes in UK. Now we are going to see passes in UK. See, there are five important passes in UK. It is Dungrila Pass, Mana Pass, Nitila Pass, Liplake Pass and Rupin Pass. See, this is very very important. Dungrila Pass is the longest pass in India. Dungrila Pass is the longest pass in India. So friends, in the exam they may ask, which is the longest pass? So the answer is Dungrila Pass. The answer is Dungrila Pass. So our target is to remember these five passes names. So let us see the trick. See, the first one, it is Dungrila Pass, right? It is Dungrila Pass. If you observe clearly, here you can see U-N-G-R-I. Its pronunciation is similar to angry. So just remember Dungrila Pass as angry. Dungrila Pass as angry. Coming to Mana Pass, here you can see M-A-N, man. So just remember it as man. Just remember it as man. He is from UK. He is from UK. So here UK means Uttarakhand. Next one, third one, Nitila Pass. Here you can see N-I-T. Its pronunciation is night. So just remember Nitila Pass as night. Nitila Pass as night. Coming to fourth one, Liplake Pass. Liplake. You can easily remember it as Liplock. Friends, don't mind. This is just for fun. Sorry, friends. This is just for fun. So just remember Liplake Pass as Liplock. Coming to fifth one, Rupin Pass. So here you can see R-U-P. If I add letter A, its pronunciation is Rupa. So in this way, we got total five new words. Angry, man, night, Liplock, Rupa. So now I am going to frame all this into a beautiful funny sentence. Let's see here. A angry man from UK at night given lip lock to Rupa. A angry man from UK at night given lip lock to Rupa. Very funny, right? So friends, my tricks will be in the similar way. So please subscribe to my channel and share my videos to your friends. You can see these similar kind of videos at An Academy. You can see all these videos at the bottom of the video. Thank you friends for watching this. Please subscribe to my channel. Thank you friends. Hi guys, this is Sandeep Reddy Kankanala, Verified Educator at An Academy. Friends, those who are feeling difficult to memorize GK and those who are not able to score good marks in GK, you can directly watch my videos, guys. These are very, very important, right? See, those who have didn't seen my previous videos, please watch. They are very, very important, unique tricks, right? Very interesting. I'm always used to relate GK with real life stories, funny stories, wife and husband stories, love stories. Very, very interesting, right? So please watch my previous videos. They will be helpful. Definitely they will be helpful to you. You will get sure you will score 60 to 80% marks easily. If you want to see these 300 videos, you can see the links below in the description, or else download An Academy app from the Play Store and you can search Sandeep Kankanala so that you can see all my videos, right? So friends, today we are going to see very, very important topic. Before going to see the topic, please subscribe to my channel and click bell icon. If you subscribe to my channel, you will get updates whenever I upload a new video. Okay friends, let's move to the topic. This is very, very important topic. Whatever the exam you write, sure we can expect one question from elements, gases. So now we are going to see facts about gases. Facts about gases. This is very, very important topic. We can expect one question in the chemistry part, right? So the first question. Gas most abundant in the earth atmosphere. Gas most abundant in the earth atmosphere is nitrogen. It is 78%. So the maximum earth atmosphere is covered by nitrogen. It is 78%. Don't get confused, right? Gas most abundant in the earth atmosphere is nitrogen. It is 78%. Next question. Percentage of oxygen in earth atmosphere. Percentage of oxygen in earth atmosphere, it is 21% approximately. 21% approximately. The lightest gas, which is the lightest gas? Hydrogen is the lightest gas. Hydrogen is the lightest gas. Which is the heaviest gas? Radon is the heaviest gas. Radon is the heaviest gas. which is called tear gas. Very, very important. See, all these three are very, very important. Which is called tear gas? Ammonia. Ammonia is called tear gas. Ammonia is called tear gas, and its formula is NH3. Its formula is NH3. What is marsh gas? What is marsh gas? Methane. Methane is called as marsh gas. You can easily remember. See, it starts with letter M. It starts with letter M. So you can easily remember, marsh gas is called as methane. Next one, laughing gas. Very, very, very important. What is laughing gas? Nitrous oxide is called laughing gas. Nitrous oxide is called laughing gas. Its formula is N2O. Its formula is N2O. What are the natural gases? Very, very important. What are natural gases? Mainly methane with small quantities of ethane and propane. Mainly methane with small quantities of ethane and propane. Next one, which is called gobar gas? Methane, carbon dioxide. See, gobar gas is covered with, gobar gas contains methane, carbon dioxide, hydrogen. Gobar gas contains methane, carbon dioxide and hydrogen. Next one, gas with foul smell. Gas with foul smell is hydrogen sulfide. Hydrogen sulfide. Next question, gas mixed with oxygen and given to the patients with resisted breathing, right? Gas mixed with oxygen and given to patients with resisted breathing is helium. Is helium. Next one, a major air pollutant, the percentage presence of which is checked in vehicle pollution test. The major air pollutant, the percentage presence of which is checked in vehicle pollution test is carbon monoxide. Is carbon monoxide. Very, very important. Next one, the gas which is responsible for the formation of brown air in traffic congested cities. The gas which is responsible for the formation of brown air in traffic congested cities is nitrogen dioxide. Is nitrogen dioxide. Major gases pollutant of areas located near thermal power station. Major gases pollutant of areas located near thermal power station is sulfur dioxide. It is sulfur dioxide. Strong smelling substance added to LPG. What is the strong smelling substance added to LPG? Ethyl merceptan and ethanol. Ethyl merceptan and ethanol. Next question. Gas responsible for the depletion of ozone layer. Gas responsible for the depletion of ozone layer is chlorofluorocarbon. Very, very, very important. Previously, I have covered this trick. You can watch my previous videos. I have covered some of the questions. Next one. Gas responsible for acid rain. Gas responsible for acid rain is sulfur dioxide. Gas responsible for acid rain is sulfur dioxide. Gas used in gas welding and also artificial ripening of fruits is acetylene. It is acetylene. Gas used in gas welding and also artificial ripening of fruits is acetylene. Gas used in electric bulb. Very, very important. Gas used in electric bulb is argon. Gas used in electric bulb is argon. Gas used in fluorescent lamps. Gas used in fluorescent lamps is mercury vapor. It is mercury vapor. Gas used in LPG. Gases used in LPG is butane, propane, ethane. Gases used in LPG is butane, ethane, propane. Gas used in refrigeration is freon. Gas used in refrigeration is freon. It is difluorodichloromethane. It is difluorodichloromethane. Gas used as an anesthetic in dental surgery is nitrous oxide. It is nitrous oxide. So friends, with this I have covered very, very important questions related to gases. All these questions were taken from the previous paper. So please do revision at least 2 to 3 times so that you can easily remember. All these questions are very, very important. And subscribe to my channel. If you want to see my previous videos, you can see the links below in the description topic wise. Thank you, friends.